Hi everyone, we are in fifth chapter, organizing. So in the previous chapter, chapter 4, we have seen the planning function, one of the management function, and we have seen in detail the planning process and all. Now we are going to study about organizing. So what is in this chapter, we will be seeing the meaning, steps, then different types of organizations, etc. So first we will see organizing meaning. Organizing essentially implies a process which coordinates human efforts, assembles resources, and integrates both into a unified whole to be utilized for achieving specific objectives, that is, organizational objectives. To organize means to bring about a good orderly structure, to frame and to put into working order. Organization is a process of bringing together physical, financial, and human resources in the best possible manner to achieve the organizational goal. So to be organized. So when we discuss about some people or even about our rooms or even our house, when we say our room is organized or my study table is well organized or very organized, that means everything in its own position. That is what organized in simple terms. Okay. Now, steps in the process of organizing. First one, identification and division of work. The total work is divided into manageable activities so that duplication of work can be avoided and then the burden of work can be shared among employees. Second one, departmentalization. Once work has been divided, then those activities which are similar in nature are grouped together. This leads to specialization. This grouping process is called departmentalization. I repeat, the grouping process is called departmentalization. Third one, assignment of duties. It is necessary to define the work of different job positions and accordingly allocate work to various employees. Once departments have been formed, each employee is placed under the charge of an individual. Then jobs are allocated to the members of each department in accordance with their skills and competencies. Fourth one, establish reporting relationship. Allocating work is not only enough, Fourth point, establish reporting relationship. Allocating work is not really enough. Each individual should also know from whom he has to take orders and to whom he is accountable. At this stage, all members of the organization are linked by authority responsibility relations. And the last point, coordination of activities. Business activity is a teamwork or group activity. The activities and efforts of different individuals and departments must be coordinated effectively to achieve the organizational goals. Now about the importance of organizing. So first importance, specialization. Since the activities are divided into convenient jobs, it encourages specialization, increased efficiency and productivity. Repetitive performance of a particular task allows a worker to gain experience in that area and leads to specialization. Next one, well-defined jobs. The jobs of managers and workers are well-defined. This helps in finding the right person for the right job and clearly defines to whom to report and from whom to take orders. Next point, optimum utilization of resources. Specific jobs are assigned to individuals and departments. This helps in avoiding delays and duplication of work. Organizing leads to proper usage of all material, financial and human resources. Then, adaptation to change. A sound organization facilitates adjustments to changes due to changing conditions in the external environment with respect to technology, markets, products, etc. The last point, promote human relations. Well-defined work, authority, responsibility, accountability, etc. will help individuals to work in a free and fair atmosphere. This will improve human relations. Next one we are going to see, formal organization. Formal organization refers to the organization structure which is designed by the management to accomplish a particular task. It specifies clearly the boundaries of authority and responsibility, and there is a systematic coordination among various activities to achieve organizational goals. According to Chester Bernard, an organization is formal when the activities of two or more persons are consciously coordinated towards a common objective. Now, what is informal organization? Interactions among people at work given rise to a network of social relationship among employees, which is called informal organization. This happens when people interact beyond their officially defined roles. The network of personal and social relationship on the basis of friendship and common interest is called informal organization. Hope you all understood. Thank you.